Good morning. Today I will share a story of last week, of which Hong Kong is a very significant part. I founded last week in Hong Kong in 2007, and it's now the company's global headquarters and also the holding company, which owns 10 subsidiaries worldwide as far as Sao Paulo, New York, Los Angeles, Milan, London, and Dubai, Singapore, many other and the other offices. My presentation is will be very visual, given the nature of our products, which is design, art, and manufacturing. What I would like to show you is basically how a Czech company with a glass tradition and crystal background, founded by my father, has joined with Hong Kong, with the brains, with the professional, marketing and salespeople, and also now with a factory in Shanghai where we manufacture our stainless steel and metal components. How this synergy between the traditional Europe, Hong Kong, and actually China is really helping us in doing our business worldwide. So, what does LASVIT do? We do bespoke luxury glass art installations. Maybe some of you will understand more if I mention decorative lighting, contemporary chandeliers, and so on. And if somebody asks me in two words, how do I define LASVIT? I would say bohemian perfection. It sounds contradictory. How can you be bohemian and perfect at the same time and vice versa? Well, we like this because we have lots of unconventional people. You should see some of our designers, and they would not wear a tie, definitely a tie, and they are very creative. And then we have some people who are very professional, who are obsessed with precision and professionalism. So combining these two kind of people in one company is very challenging, but it's what makes us different. So, as I mentioned, the presentation will be quite visual, so allow me to first play a short video, which I will not play the full video, of course, just 1.5 minutes. It shows our exhibition in Milan earlier this year. And I like the song very much, by the way.
I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the pandango? Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me.
LASVIT is based in the Czech Republic, and we are one of the world's leaders in custom-made glass art installations. Modern chandeliers, contemporary glass sculptures, and so on. At one point, we felt, let's do something different. Let's do something that hasn't been done yet. We thought of several designers, and Fabio Novembre is a good friend of mine, and then Fabio brought in two more designers. Okay, Nendo from Japan, and Matthew Lehaner from France. We are Bohemians, we are from Bohemia, which is the western part of Czech Republic. So Bohemian Rhapsody was kind of a natural topic.
Easy come. Go, will you let me go?
Ho pensato a questo brano dei Queen che mi ha sempre appassionato moltissimo, è Bohemian Rhapsody, no? Però ho cercato veramente di materializzare.
So I wish we had time for the full movie. I'm sure you'd enjoy it, but we are more interested in answering your questions. So let me proceed and show you the first and one of my favorite projects that we have done in Hong Kong earlier this year, the Ritz-Carlton Hong Kong. It's the tallest hotel in the world. We did most of the public areas. We have very good relationship with San Hung Kei, the very famous Hong Kong developer. And we have been working on many of their projects in Asia Pacific and China and elsewhere. So I'll just show you some of the areas. This is the Chinese restaurant. Princess Building is another interesting project that I have enjoyed overseeing. In China, with the Shangri-La Group, we do a lot of projects. So again, we work with many Hong Kong developers, actually on projects all over Asia. So this is, for example, the China World Summit Wing. the tallest building in Beijing. Fairmont Beijing. In addition to hotels, we do also shopping malls. So this is another, this is the most luxurious shopping mall in China, the IFC Mall in Pudong. And each of our pieces, they always have a story. So this piece was inspired by the life in the universe, for example. We don't sell just products. We like to sell, we sell art, and each art piece has a certain story behind. Another project inspired by fluidity. In Macau, it's the city of dreams, 6 meter by 6 meter sea anemone. This is the only Shangri-La in Japan, the Shangri-La Tokyo. We have done about 20 Tiffany stores worldwide, all the flagship store. This is the one in Taipei. Project in India. I have just picked one example from, you know, different parts of Asia Pacific, plus, for example, projects later. You will see projects from outside as well, from Middle East and US. This is the Marina Bay Sands, Singapore, project in Indonesia. This is a metro. I hope one day we can do something with the MTR, but it doesn't seem likely yet. Hopefully in a few more years. Some examples of projects in Europe. This is the Savoy in London. This was the Four Seasons Park Lane. With Philippe Starck, famous French designer, we did a project in Miami. In addition to big, large installations, we also do trophies for famous celebrities. So this was for Tour de France. We did the trophy for this year for the winner and all the other three winners under 25 years old and so on. You probably, the Masters just finished, the Masters tournament in London with Roger Federer winning the tournament. This was earlier, this was last year's Mubadala World Tennis Championships, where Roger Federer and Rafael Nadal won our trophies. We are sponsoring this tournament this year again. We also do a lot of trade fairs, so these are some examples I picked. This is from the 100% Design London, from France. And we also sell collections for homes. So we don't only do hotels. We also do residential properties, small houses, I mean, actually large houses, not small houses. And we have glass sculptures and other collectibles. The latest product is the crystal wall, which is the only wall that unites. Now, how is this made? This building is our glass factory in Czech Republic. It may seem like a bakery, but actually it's a glass factory. And inside we have 65, you know, glass blowers who have learned from their fathers and grandfathers. They are not ordinary glass blowers. They are more artists. They are artisans. There are some images from the production. So this was the little background of Last Week, and now why Hong Kong, and why is Hong Kong so significant for us? So obviously Hong Kong is significant for us because we have the global headquarters here. So everything we run globally is now run from Hong Kong, where I have been living for the last 12 years. It's also our sales and market headquarters for Asia Pacific, from where we generate more than 30% of our revenues. We have Len Crawford as our retail agent in Hong Kong since 2010. And by now, we sell to most Hong Kong developers to their properties basically worldwide. This year, we also did this little unique thing, the Ambassador's Ball. Maybe some of you have heard about it. It was a charity event to support the Hong Kong design community. We donated a very unique trophy, and it was the top prize of the whole event. So why Hong Kong? I think we will all agree geography must be the number one reason, because it's just a perfect location here. It's 4 hours flight to Tokyo, it's 2 hours to Shanghai, it's close to China, close to Beijing, 4 hours to Singapore, Indonesia. It's a really great location, and If you ask 10 people, eight of them, I think, will tell you it's the best location if you want to do business in Asia Pacific. The second reason we chose Hong Kong are the people here. The people, I think Jim mentioned here earlier today that they are very flexible, and I agree. The people in Hong Kong are just much more flexible. I don't want to say anything bad about Chinese, mainland Chinese, but definitely compared to Shanghai, Hong Kong people are much more flexible. And we as a European company, we like the leaders, the bosses in our company, we like to be when we are challenged by our staff, which doesn't happen in mainland China. Here, my staff, they actually challenge us, and that's a great thing, because then the company can really develop and have more ideas and be more flexible. So, ease of establishing, well, setting up a business in Hong Kong is probably as difficult, as easy, I would say as easy as in Singapore, and definitely much, much easier than Shanghai. Basically, I would like to compare Singapore and Shanghai, you know, to Hong Kong in this part of my presentation. Clients-wise, if you are in this luxury business or hotel development business or anything related to high value-added products, then Hong Kong is the place. There are the most developers in Asia. There are the most architects and designers in Asia Pacific. For us, it's just the perfect location, better than Hong Kong, better than Singapore, Shanghai. And well, by entertainment and restaurants, I don't just mean Lan Kwai Fong. I think Hong Kong just has amazing food, and it's really a great place to be. I personally like hiking, so countryside for me. When I came to Hong Kong, I thought it was just concrete jungle. By now, I have been to many parts of the new territories, to Tai Lung Wah, and I think some of these beaches there are as nice as in Thailand. So I was very impressed, and I think all these points together make Hong Kong really, for us, you know, a great place. When we say positive things, we should mention maybe two negative things, is the air quality. I hope that this will improve in the near future. And finally, as I learned earlier today, with the cultural new district, I think the relative lack of cultural events will also improve. Because obviously, being from Prague originally, we have the highest number of theaters per person in the world in Prague. Hong Kong is definitely doesn't have so many concerts and interesting performances. So I think that now is the best cultural district, which I just learned will finish by 2016. This should improve a lot as well. So basically, Hong Kong is the winner out of Shanghai and out of all the other parts of Asia Pacific. And I think LastSuite is very grateful to Hong Kong. And I'm not afraid to say that if it was not for Hong Kong, LastSuite would not be where it is right now. So thank you very much.